Do you know what type of injuries can occur involving the volar plates in the fingers? On ultrasound, the volar plates appear as echogenic, homogeneous, fibrocartilaginous structures that run along the volar aspect of the finger joints, deep to the flexor tendons. They connect two bones in each finger joint and are continuous with the articular surface. The volar plate inserts onto the joint capsule and functions to limit joint hyperextension. The volar plates can get injured from extension at the involved joint. The most common cause of this injury is during sports involving a ball forcing the finger backwards. When the finger is bent too far backwards, it can tear the ligament or cause an intra-articular fracture. With that being said, the two types of injuries that can occur involving the volar plates in the fingers are 1, tears in the volar plate, which on ultrasound appear as hypoechoic or anechoic defects in the volar plate, or 2, an avulsion injury in which a bony fragment detaches from the affected bone. On ultrasound, this will appear as small displaced hyperechoic ossification. The volar plate of the PIP joint is most vulnerable to hyperextension injury. I hope that helps when you're performing a volar plate ultrasound. Ultrasound is a really valuable tool to assess the volar plate stability using real-time dynamic evaluation.